वंदे गुरु परंपरां श्रुति स्मृति पुराणानां पालयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्र भाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेद विभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्त देहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। सहना भवतु, सहनौ भुनक्तु, सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः। यो ब्रह्माण विदाति पूर्वं वेदाश्च प्रणोति तस्मै तवं हृदयमात्मबुद्धिप्रकाशं मुमुक्षुर्वै शरणमहं प्रपद्ये। शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः। श्रीचिद्भरगणेशाय नमो। मह्यं सुखं नित्यं सुप्रकाशं व्यापकं नाम रूप अधिष्ठानं बुद्धिबोध्यं बुद्धेर्यस्य निर्मलं पारं सर्ववेदान्तवेद्यं प्रत्यक्परं महः सदैवाहन्नमोऽस्मि इति निश्चितामतिः। ब्रह्मज्ञानस्य प्रत्यक्षत्व उपपत्ति ही तत्व दृष्टे भेद भ्रम निवृत्तिश्च। यू आर लुकिंग एट दिस यस्टरडे। बाह्य घटादि भी सह अंतकरण वृत्ते संबंधो नेत्रादि इंद्रिय द्वारा जायते इति घटादयो न साक्षी भास्यः। व्हेन द विषय हैज इंद्रिय संबंध दैट टाइम दे आर नॉट कॉल्ड अ साक्षी भाष्य। प्रमाता इज इन्वॉल्वड देयर। So, when the Indriya is connected with the Vishaya, then Antakkarana going out with the Indriya takes a Ghatakara Vritti. The Antakkarana takes a Ghatakara Vritti. Thereby, when Antakkarana takes the Ghatakara, Ghatadiyakara, that time the Sakshi is not involved. Sakshi is not involved. It's Sakshi as Sakshi. He cannot be called a Sakshi because Antakkarana connection is there. And that Antakkarana is connected with the Vishaya. Thereby, through the Vritti, of course, Antakkarana modifies in the form of the Vritti. Therefore, Ghatadayana Sakshi Bhasya. The Abhasa within the Antakkarana lights it up, not the Sakshi. The Vritti is lit up, Ghata the Vritti, and thereby the Ghata, Adi, are lit up by the Abhasa within the Antakkarana. They cannot be called as Sakshi Bhasya. Antakkarana Vrittir Yada Brahmakara Bhavati. In the case of Brahmajnana, Vishaya is Brahma, Brahmatma, therefore Vritti takes Brahmakara. तदा सा वृत्ति ही न बहिर्गच्छति। ऑल्दो ब्रह्मा इज ऑल परवेजिव व्यापक तत्व, स्टिल वृत्ति रिमेन्स विद इन। इट डज नॉट नीड टू गो आउट बिकॉज ब्रह्मा इज एवरीवेयर। इट इज देयर वेयर द प्रमाता इज, वेयर द अंतकरण इज, where the vritti is taking place within, there itself Brahma is there. Vishaya is exactly where the pramatadi is there, where the shrota is there when shravana takes place. Therefore, the vritti he does not need to go out. Yada brahma kara bhavati tada sa vritti hi na bhair gacchati. किंतु शरीर से अंतरायो वर्तते सेज विदिन तया वृत्त्या सह ब्रह्मण संबंधो अस्ति। विषय संबंध इज देयर, विषय बीइंग ब्रह्म, वृत्ति इज कनेक्टेड टू द विषय। तस्माद् ब्रह्म ज्ञानोपि सुख दुखादि ज्ञानम इव प्रत्यक्ष रूपम भवति। सो इफ तत्वदृष्टि हैड अ कन्फ्यूजन एज टू इंद्रिय संबंध मेक्स दी विषय प्रत्यक्ष एंड देयर बाय विषय ज्ञान प्रत्यक्ष दैट इज नॉट सो बिकॉज अंतकरण वृत्ति लाइक सुखाकार दुखाकार वृत्ति कैन टेक प्लेस विदाउट इंद्रिय संबंध एंड स्टिल रिमेन प्रत्यक्ष. परंतु सुखाकार दुखाकार वृत्तिषु बाह्य साधनापेक्षा नास्ति. देयर इज नो बाह्य देयर इज नो डिपेंडेंसी ऑन आउटवर्ड मींस लाइक इंद्रिय तस्मा सुख दुखादयः साक्षी भाष्य. देयर इज अ सम ऑफ यू हैव सीन दिस मल्टीपल टाइम्स नाउ. सुख दुखास आर साक्षी भाष्य आदि पदेन यू कैन से इवन दी भ्रम. ब्रह्माकार अंतकरण वृत्तौ तु गुरुमुखाज श्रुत वेदांत वाक्यस्य श्रोत्रेन्द्रिय संबंध रूप बाह्य साधनम अपेक्षते. इन ब्रह्मज्ञान ऑल्दो इंद्रिय इज नॉट कनेक्टेड विद द विषय वृत्ति इज कनेक्टेड विद द विषय स्टिल व्हाट इज हैपनिंग इज दैट ब्रह्माकार अंतकरण वृत्तौ तु अंतकरण वृत्ति इज टेकिंग प्लेस इट मॉडिफाइज इन द फ्रॉम in keeping with Brahma Sarupa. There the Shravana is needed. Shrotrendriya is needed because Shravana has to take place as means to Jnana. Thereby Guru Mukhat Shruta Vedanta Vakyasya. When the Mahavakya is understood on hearing the Mahavakya and its explanation, or explanation and then the Mahavakya again, then the Mahavakya creates a Shabda Bodha. When it is creating a Shabda Bodha, that Shabda Bodha can take place when one hears the Shabda. While listening to that Shabda in the Vakya, Shabda Bodha is Vakya Bodha really. Guru Mukhat Shruta Vedanta Vakyasya, that Vedanta Vakya, which is heard from the Guru, Shrotrendriya Sambandha Rupa Bahya Sadhanam Apekshate Tasya. There is an Apeksha you can hear only when the Shrotra Golaka is functioning, Shrotrendriya is functioning. Thereby, Shrotrendriya Sambandha Rupa Bahya Sadhanam is needed. तस्मात् ब्रह्मण साक्षी भाष्यम. सो फार इंद्रिय संबंध वेर एवर इज नॉट नीडेड देर इट इज साक्षी भाष्य. दिस वॉज एस्टैब्लिश्ड इन द केस ऑफ सुख दुखादि भ्रम. सो वन मे थिंक दैट फॉर ब्रह्म एज विषय इंद्रिय संबंध इजंट देर वृत्ति संबंध इज देर. Thereby it is also Sakshi Bhasya. No, it is not Sakshi Bhasya. Why? Because Brahmakarantakarna Vuttavtu Guru Mukhat Shruta Vedanta Vakyasya Shrutrendriya Sambandha Rupa Bahya Sadhana Apeksha. So Bahya Sadhana Apeksha is there. So it is refined now. Indriya having Vishaya Sambandha was said to be that which differentiate from Shakshi Bhasya. It was actually brought up in the case of Pratyaksha. There has to be Sambandha with the Vishaya. That is there, therefore Pratyakshatvam is established in Brahma. Now it is being refined as there is a dependency to make whether it is, to know whether it is Sakshi Bhasya or not. One has to know whether the indriya dependency is there. There is an indriya dependency for the vritti. For the vritti to take place, which vritti? Shabdakara vritti. Then it turns out to be brahmakara, once understood. But to have that shabdakara vritti, shabdavoda to take place, there is an expectancy of shrotrendriya. Shrotrendriya Sambandha Rupa. Thereby, Brahma is not Sakshi Bhasya. There is a tippana there. The first was brahmakara antakrana vrittir yada brahmakara bhavati. So we'll look at that and come back. So why brahmakara is mentioned? Antakrana yavat antakrana yadi antakranam yadi said antakrana vritti antakrana vrittir yada brahmakara bhavati. There brahmakara is commented upon by Swamiji. He says chakshu suryo jayata Aditya Chakshur Bhutva. There is a typo here. Bhutva Akshini Pravishat. Taittiriya Upanishad has these mantras. Taittiriya also has something similar. Purusha Sukta has something similar. Taittiriya Brahmana, not Upanishad. Aranyaka otherwise. So, Chakshu Surya Jayata. Surya was born from Chakshu. Who's Chakshu? That Vishwarupa, Virat, or Ishvara. Aditya Chakshur Bhutva. Aditya Surya himself becomes the Chakshu by becoming the presiding deity. Adishthatra Devata for Chakshu. Akshini Pravishata. Having become the Chakshur Indriya, he entered the eyes. So these mantras are there. Ityadi Pramanena Chakshushi Suryo Surya Bhedo Asti. Abheda, Chakshu and Chakshurindriya and Surya, Abheda is known through the Upanishad Pramana. There is an Abheda between in the Chakshu, there is a Surya Abheda. That's why there is an Upasana where, you know, Akshipurusha, the Suryantargata Devata, who is Hiranyagarbha, Samashti, that Samashti is meditated upon the, upon as Akshigata Purusha. In the right eye, there is Purusha, that Purusha who is me. I am a Vyashti. But there is Abheda between that kind of a Vyashti me and is Samashti Surya, Suryantargata Hiranyagarbha. So there is an Upasana like this. When it is understood, then it becomes Jnana. When it is said you do this, when it is not understood, it is an Upasana. But why you are doing it? Is it for some phala? Some siddhi? Some darshana, or is it for jnana? For it will, if it is not for any of the phala, then it will cause chitta shuddhi. And shravana, which has taken place already, this itself, no abheda, when there is an abheda, in the chakshu is there. I myself am pervading the chakshu also. And at the samashti level, by Gayatri Mantra also, who is the Upasya Devata? Savita Devata. Savitra Devata. Who is Surya or Aditya? Who is none other than Hiranyagarbha? Who is none other than Ishvara? Therefore, Tattvamasi Mahavakya is there even in Karma Kanda. Here it is in Aitareya Upanishad. But then in Purusha Sukta, one can understand that it is also teaching Aikya. Even in the Upasana, Aikya is being taught. When that is understood, then Upasana is no longer Upasana. It is Manana. It becomes Mahavakya Shravana when heard from the Guru. Thereby, one knows that it is all Aikya that is the focus of Veda Vedanta. Anyway, in the context, Angulyadi Rupa Alpavaranena Surya Tirodhane Brahmanantarvarti Suryasya Prakashana Drushyate Avarna Nivruttavutu Chakshurgata Antakrana Vrutya Brahmanantarvarti Suryasya Vrutihi Suryasya Prakashana Drushyate Eva Meva Sakshi Rupi Atmani. I'll just, you know, complete this. I'll give you some shape. Eva Meva Sakshi Rupi Atmani Brahmano Abheda Vasti Tasya Antakrana Gata Ajnanausha Rupa Swalpa Avaranena Achadane सर्वत्र परिपूर्ण ब्रह्मण प्रत्यक्षतया भासते। यदा शरीरांतर जायमान ब्रह्मात्मा भेदाकार वृत्त्या पूर्वोक्तावरणस्य भंगो जायते तदा ग्रहांतर्गतस्य आकाशस्य असंगत्वादि ज्ञानेन महाकाशस्य असंगत्वादि ज्ञानोदयवत् सर्वत्र परिपूर्ण ब्रह्मणः सप्रकाशत्व रूपेण भानं भवति। टू एग्जांपल्स आर यूज, वन इज दी थ्रू दिस अभेदा विच इज टॉक्ड अबाउट विद द उपासना और इवन ज्ञानकांड। There, who is this Purusha in the Akshigata Purusha? In the right eye, the Purusha is Angulyadi Rupa Alpavarnena Surya Tirodhane. Here, it has said that, you know, if you close your eyes, the Purusha within is known, the Surya who is Pratyaksha to the Chakshurindriya, a huge celestial body, so to say, can be missed out just by covering your eyes with your fingers, closing your eyes basically. So if there is an avarna on your eyes, not on Surya, if there is an avarna on your eyes, then this Surya becomes covered as though there is avarna on Surya. Now similar is the unmissable prakasha of Chaitanya, which happens to be your own Swarupa, but it can also be missed by an avarana on the buddhi, really, when the inquiry is not done. That's why vicharam na sahate, avarana, which is a maya shakti, which creates vikshepa of duality, plurality, vicharam na sahate, it will not stand scrutiny. So what is the reason for avarna to continue? Because scrutiny is lacking. Vichara is not being done. So just an avarna, little avarna on the capacity to do vichara, really. If you think further, what is this avarna on the atma, brahmatma, which is swayam prakasha, and even the Aditya Prakasha, Surya Prakasha is due to Brahmatma Prakasha. That kind of Brahmatma, how can it be hidden by Avarna? How can it be veiled? Just like Surya can be veiled by veiling your own eyes. You cover your eyes, the Surya is covered as though. Similarly, you do not do Vichara, you cover your Buddhi. Brahmatma is covered as though. So Angulyadi Rupa Alpavarnena Surya Tirodhane Brahmanantarvarti Suryasya Prakashana Drishyate. You don't see the Surya Prakasha, although it's a bright day and at noon. Still, the Surya Prakasha is not seen if your eyes are covered. Avarna Nivruttautu Chakshurgata Antakkarana Vrutya Vrutya Dishudhi Vrutya ब्रह्मांतरवर्ति सूर्यस्य प्रकाशो दृश्यते। दिस अंतकरणवृत्ति इज थ्रू द चक्षु। व्हेन देयर इज एन आवरण निवृत्ति, यू टेक अवे योर फिंगर्स कवरिंग द आईज, देन व्हाट विल हैपन, देयर इज एन अंतकरणवृत्ति which is Surya Prakashakara, and then Brahmanantarvarti Suryasya Prakasha Drushyate. Similarly, Eva Meva Sakshi Rupe Atmani Brahmano Abhedo Asti. There is an Abheda, just like there is an Abheda between the Akshi Purusha and Hiranyagarbha Vyashti Samashti. Vyashti Samashti in the Upasana itself. Similarly, there is Abheda between Vyashti me and Samashti Ishvara. Between Atma and Brahma, there is Abheda. Tasya antakkarnagata ajnanamsha rupa svalpavarnena achhadane sarvatra paripurnam brahmana pratyakshataya bhasate. A little avarna It cannot really cover Brahma, but what is happening? We have to say it covers Brahma as though just like the Surya is veiled. Similarly, easily veiling, which is lack of vichara really, for the ajnana to continue. All you need to know, do is open your eyes to see Surya. Similarly, all you need to do is vichara, opening up your mind, buddhi. That is a comparison here, but anyway, it is in the context of Brahmakara Vritti. Then Pratyaksha, what is Pratyaksha? Just like Surya is Pratyaksha by removing the fingers covering your eyes. What is happening? All that is happening is you have removed the fingers covering your eyes, then the Chakshurindriya does what it does. No additional thing is needed because Chakshurindriya, which was covered, is no longer covered. It will connect with the Vishaya. Vishaya is so bright, you cannot miss it. And Jnana will take place no matter whether you have Kartrutva or not. Whether you consider yourself as a seer or not, the Chakshurindriya will connect with the Vishaya, the Vritti will take place, and the Surya Prakasha will be revealed. Similarly, just by taking away the Avarna, Sakshatkara will take place. It will be Pratyaksha. You cannot avoid Pratyakshatvam of Brahma, which is ever Pratyaksha as Atma, Ahantaya. How have we avoided it? It cannot be avoided. It is avoided by just covering ourselves up. By not doing vichara. By letting the ajnana continue. So veil is continuing. Even then the Surya Prakasha is still there. It is as bright. Just like, you know, the cat drinks milk by closing its eyes, it thinks nobody is watching. The entire world remains as it is. The cat isn't seeing the world. We don't see the Surya just by covering up our eyes. Does not mean that the Surya isn't there. Similarly, when avidya is continuing, even then we don't cognize, we do not understand this Brahmatma Tattva, Aikya Jnana isn't there. But Aikya is always there. Brahma is ever there. It is my own Swarupa. I miss it by veiling myself. Pratyaksha, it is ever Pratyaksha. But the Jnana isn't Pratyaksha. It will take place automatically when every misunderstanding is taken away. Then the self-shining Tattva that I am will shine forth without any obstacles. I was ever shining, but there were obstacles which had to be removed at that point of time. When I remove them, then this shine is as though Pratyaksha, which was ever Pratyaksha, is now as though Pratyaksha, because the Jnana about that shine is Pratyaksha. The Chaitanya is Pratyaksha. Now, it feels it is Pratyaksha now, although it was ever Pratyaksha, because the Jnana regarding that Chaitanya is Pratyaksha now. So, Yada Shariranthara Jayamana Brahmatma Abhedakara Vrutya Purvokta Avarnasya Bhango Jayate. Avarna, Ajnana is taken away, meaning Avarna goes away. Tada Grahantargatasya Akashasya. Asangatvadi jnanena mahakashasya asangatvadi jnana udayavat. Just like the ghatakasha mahakasha aikya is known, similarly, sarvatra paripurna brahmana svaprakashatva rupena bhanam bhavati. Which was always paripurna brahma and always svaprakasha, but svaprakasha is as well known. Is known, not as well, it is known as well. So initially when the chapter began, that time there was a twofold question. Brahmanasti Nabhati. So Astitva Jnana taking place as Aham, not Paroksha Aparokshataya, not Brahma Asti, but Brahma Asti via Brahma Asmi. So Us is there, Us Dhatu is there. Asabhumi, that Dhatu is there. And Bhu Sattayam, so Sattartha Dhatu is there. In Asti also, Asmi also. So Satta is known. So Brahma Asti Jnana takes place in the Aparoksha Vakya as well. Mahavakya. Tattvam Asi. There also, in the Madhyama Purusha, Us is there. Sattarthe. And in Asmi also, Us is there. In Asti anyway, it is clear. But in Asi and Asmi also, Aham Brahmasmi, there also, Satta is there in the Dhatu. Thereby, Astitva Jnana takes place. So, Nasti Nabhati, in that, Nasti is resolved as Asti. Then, Bhanam Katham Bhavati. Nabhati, by this, Pratyaksha Jnana, Paripurna Brahmana, Swaprakashatva Rupena, Bhanam Bhavati. So, now, Nabhati has changed to Bhati. Aham Bhami. That's how the Jnana will take place. I am Chaitanya Swarupa, Sat Rupa, and finally Ananta Ananda Rupa. That is Brahmakara Vritti. Then there is another Sakshi Bhasyam. Tasmat Brahmana Sakshi Bhasyam. There the Tippanakara says, Yatha Brahmana Sakshi Bhasyam Tatha Chidabhasa Sahita Antakkarana Vritti Rupa Pramatuhu api agocharam bhavati. So incidentally, he says that just like Brahma is not Sakshi Bhasya, what about this Chidabhasa Sahita Antakkarana Vritti Rupa Pramata? Who is Pramata? Pramata is Chaitanya along with the Antakkarana, along with the Abhasa. So there are three components. So Chidabhasa Sahita Antakkarana Vritti Rupa Pramata. Pramata is also in the form of Vritti. We say the Triputi. Here we have seen four components, but generally we see Triputi. When we say Triputi, Prameya, Pramata and Pramana. These three things are there. Then here we looked at Prama also. The Pramana, Prameya, Pramatru Bheda, which is there, that is Vritti Bheda. All segmentation can be created only in the Antakkarana. That Antakkarana segmentation is, at least it is manifest in the Antakkarana. It is there at the Avidya level also, of course. But then Avidya level, in Sushupti, you don't know any differences. There are no differences. Only veiling is there. That's why Aikya is not known, Avarana being there. But where the king and the servant become one, the tiger and the mosquito become one, Ishvara and Jiva become one in Sushupti. So Avidya keeps a veil, but there is no individuality till there is Vijnanamaya Kosha. When Vijnanamaya Kosha becomes active, then alone there is division. Sakshi, Pramata, then alone Pramana, Prameya, all these are possible. So in the Triputi, when we think about the Triputi also, there Pramata is me, but I am also in the form of Vritti because I am connected with the Antakkarana. And I know myself as a Pramata. Who can be called as a Pramata? Only when there is a Prameya. Then alone Pramana will become active. And Prama will take place. So this Pramata is Antakkarana Vritti Rupa. That Antakkarana Vritti Rupa, not just Jada Antakkarana, but there is Chaitanya Abhasa also. I am really Chaitanya. Sakshi Chaitanya. But associated with the Antakkarana, एंड रिफ्लेक्टिंग एज चिदाभासा द कॉम्बिनेशन इज चिदाभास सहित अंतकरण वृत्ति रूप प्रमाता एंड तस्य प्रमातुहु अपि तस् नॉट तस्य यथा ब्रह्मण साक्षीभाष्यम तथा चिदाभास सहित अंतकरण वृत्ति रूप प्रमातुहु अपि अगोचरम भवति सह अपि प्रमातुर अपि अगोचरम भवति ब्रह्म न साक्षी भाष्यम तथा चिदाभास सहित अंतकरण वृत्ति रूप प्रमातुर अपि अगोचरम भवति दीपांतरापेक्षां विना केवल नेत्रस्य यथा दीपो विषयो भवति तथा ब्रह्म केवलायः अहं ब्रह्मास्मि इति ब्रह्माकार अंतकरण वृत्तेः विषयतां प्रतिपद्यते यू हैव सीन दिस द वृत्ति विषय एंड देयर बाय वृत्ति इज कनेक्टेड विद द विषय दीपांतरापेक्षां विना जस्ट लाइक अ लैंप हैज नो डिपेंडेंसी ऑन द ऑन अनदर दीप अनदर लैंप Hence is just the netra vishaya, not the vishaya of another deepa. Similarly, Brahma kevalayaha am brahmasmi iti brahmakara antakkarna vrittir vishayatam pratipadyate. Just like deepa is a netra vishaya and not deepantara vishaya. Similarly, Brahma atma is aham kevala brahma aham brahmasmi वृत्ति विषय नॉट अनदर ब्रह्म विषय नॉट अनदर चैतन्य विषय सो प्रमातुरपि अगोचरं भवति देयर ब्रह्म इज नॉट साक्षी भाष्य एंड नॉट गोचर फॉर प्रमाता ऑल्सो Because Pramata is Chaitanya. This is not Chaitanya Vishaya. One Chaitanya is not another Chaitanya Vishaya. Here it is the same Chaitanya. Why here? Everywhere it is the same Chaitanya. So Chaitanya is never a Vishaya for Chaitanya. So Vishaya is for the Vritti. Brahma is not the Vishaya. Brahma Chaitanya is not the Vishaya for Pramatra Chaitanya also. The vritti vishaya. Tasmat, so it is some hair splitting is being done. Tasmat brahmana pramatru bhasyam api. So brahma is not pramatru bhasya. Why? It's not sakshi bhasya, not pramatru bhasya also. Because not a vishaya. Not an object at all really. Kintu saprakasham pratyan सप्रकाशं प्रति किंतु सप्रकाशं प्रति प्रति अन्य प्रकाशापेक्षा रहित सर्वावभासक स्वयं प्रकाश स्वरूपं ब्रह्म सो हाउ डज द महावाक्य वर्क दिस इज डेल्ट विद इन डिटेल इन मांडुक्य उपनिषद आल्सो इट पुल्स द कारपेट अंडर योर लेग्स यू नो स्टैंडिंग ऑन दैट इज द आधार इट पुल्स दैट आधार आल्सो डू नॉट हैव एनी आधार डिपेंडेंसी ऑन एनीथिंग Everything is needed to know that nothing more is needed. It is all needed to take away the erroneous understanding. Mahavakya also works not by telling you this is it, by pointing out because yato vacho nivartante aprapya manasa saha. How does Mahavakya work? Even the Mahavakya works in the neti neti prakriya. Na iti na iti. It keeps on taking away misunderstanding after misunderstanding. When Satchidananda Brahmatvam Asi is known, then Sat, Chit and Ananta are also Lakshana by taking away misunderstanding. Even the Lakshana Vakya, not only Mahavakya, or rather Lakshana Vakya and Mahavakya both. How do they work? All these Vakyas work by taking away misunderstanding. When one part of misunderstanding is taken, then the flip side may remain or may become dhrida or may come in. If it is said you are not karya, jagat is karya, sharira is karya, antakarna buddhi is all karya, you are not karya. Oh, then I am karana because when you negate the karya in a pair, then karana remains or comes to forefront. Because karyatvam is denied. Tvam karyam na asi. When it is understood in this manner, when guru is teaching, that time, oh, aham tu karanam. But that also has to be taken away. So, na karyam na karanam. You are not outside. Oh, then I remain inside. You are neither inside nor outside. You are inside and outside. Because there is this inside and outside are words with a boundary. That boundary you have created with the sharira. Sharira is mithya, boundary is mithya, inward, outward, words are mithya. Namakruta bheda is mithya. So the each and every part of the pair, when we reject, the other either comes to forefront, comes alive, or it remains if it has already been there and becomes dridha. That also has to be taken away. When tattvamasi is said, then you are not this limited jiva. You are not alpajna. You are not alpasharira van. You are not karya. You are not karana. All these are taken away as and one understands, as and when one understands the Mahavakya. So Mahavakya also works in the neti neti prakriya. It does not make Brahma's vishaya. It is a vritti vishaya. It is not the vishaya for the pramata. It is a vritti vishaya, means it is the subject matter of the vritti, not the object of the vritti. Although we understand it as an object, it cannot be objectified by any shabda, vakya, any indriya. Mana also, we have seen this, yato vacho nivartante aprapya manasa, aprapyatvam kim? Aprapyatvam is not being able to objectify. But still it is a vishaya. How so? It is a subject matter. It is the subject, this very content of the subject and the object. So what is going to happen is that it will never be the vishaya at all. Although it is grammatically a vishaya, it will not be a vishaya in that sense of an object as a karma. Grammatically in analysis, yes. In sentence analysis, yes, vishaya. It will take the karma, position of karma, but never objectifiable at all. When all the objectification is taken away by neti neti prakriya, then what you remain without any associations of sharira ityadi, you are self-shining Satchidananda Brahma. And what kind of Satchidananda Brahma? Sat negates asat, chit negates achit, ananta or ananda both counter by countering antavatvam. Anantyam takes away antavatvam, which was the cause for sorrow, which was the search to become complete paripurna. In each aspect, I want to be fulfilled, because that fulfillment brings me ananda. So the search is really for ananda. That ananda also manifests itself. So this is the way the vritti works. Kintu svaprakasham prati anya prakasha apeksha rahita sarvavabhasaka swayam prakasha swarupam brahma. Brahma, that I am atma, is svaprakasha. When every other connection is taken away, I am known as self-shining. I was ever self-shining. It is pratyaksha to me now. And towards that svaprakasha me, Brahma, anya prakasha apeksha isn't there. So rahita sarvavabhasaka, that kind of me who has ever been ever revealing and ever revealing everything, even the misunderstandings have been revealed by my self-shining nature. Jnana, ajnana, both are lit up. by the same Brahma Chaitanya, which is me, my Swarupa, that kind of me who reveals everything needs no other revealer. Who I reveal cannot reveal me. They have dependency on me. Otherwise, it will be an infinite regress. So the indriyas, manaha, every other entity revealed by me cannot be my revealer. I am self-revealing. I have no expectancy of any other. And that is Sakshatkara. Malena malam hanyat iti nyayena vrittir brahmana avarna bhangam karoti. What is the role of vritti then when you talk about vishaya? Really, it is Brahma being a vishaya. It is actually Brahma known through Mahavakya. Therefore, Mahavakya working there in the vritti, malena malam hanyat. It takes away vritti. Just like mala takes away mala. Old school village side, if you know, if anybody has used, I mean, the Shastras say that to wash the mala out, if you want to wash your hands, you have to wash it thrice with earth. You take up mud and wash your hands thrice with water. This is the real purity. Now that earth has been replaced by some kind of other earth. What is it? I mean, you see all this, this multani mitti and all that, you know, the soap. It is mitti finally. What is it? It is all earth. So instead of picking up mud, which is available, now it is all dirty. So they'll pack dirt and sell you with branding, with some world famous actor selling it to you. So we shell out a lot of money to buy dirt, and then with that dirt, we take away bodily dirt. That is soap. That is the definition of soap, lakshana. Soap lakshana. So malena malam hanyat. Finally, what are you doing? You have to wash away that multani mitti or whatever you have thrown on yourself. The foam has to be taken away. The soap also is dirt. It can't remain. If you step out of the bath with the soap in your ears or somewhere, somebody looks at it, looks disgusting. So they'll tell you why? Because it is dirt. Although it is a dirt, which it is dirt used to wash off your dirt, still it is dirt, it has to be washed away with water. Malena malam hanyat iti nyayena vrittir brahmana avarna bhangam karoti. So the avarna is mala, definitely mala, which has kept us in samsara. But what is this vritti? Vritti is also mala. You can't have the vritti stay. There are people who insist that vritti should stay. Hey, vritti staying, vritti is mala. Vritti is an additional add-on to you. You have to remain as Brahma. If you keep on having the vritti, aham brahmasmi vritti, brahmakara vritti, you are Brahma. You don't need a vritti. That vritti is useless. As we have seen earlier, vritti is useless, as useless for Brahmajnani as it is for avataras or Ishvara. For them it is swabhavika. For the jnani, it has become swabhavika. But that vritti has no use at all. If it is there or not there, it is irrelevant because it has no role to play. Why insist on a vritti? There are people who insist on a vritti. Why? Specifically to divorce ourselves from yoga. Oh, we are not yogis. It's dvesha to say that we are different from the yogi. Why do you need to say that? If you are really jnani, why do you need to differentiate yourself from anything? It is in the form of everything. Atma with the vritti. If the vritti, is the vritti atma or not? You cannot say that vritti is atma. If you say vritti is another than the atma, then be it mithya, it is still there. Now, if there is an effort involved, then the jnani may be there. The jnani may have jnana, but that jnani's level is lesser. If he is working on the mithyatva, he has to reject this vritti, whatever vritti, and hold on to the aikya vritti. Still, nishtha isn't there. Nishtha is not automatic. Nishtha is with prayatna. That's why the gradations of jnani is not in jnana. In jnani, there are gradations. Sapta bhumis are mentioned in Yoga Vasishta. Yoga Vasishta, yeah. So, anyway. So, malam malena hanyat iti nyayana vrittir brahmana avarana bhanga karoti soyam vritti prayukta avarana bhanga yo vrittya brahmano vishayi karanam ityuchyate. That is called as vishayi karanam. It is not literal. It is not literal that there is vishaya. The vrittya bhanga, so vritti making avarana bhanga, ajnana avarana bhanga, avriti bhanga is figuratively called as brahma is vishaya. Brahma is never a vishaya really. Brahma reveals on its own by taking away the avarana. Thereby it is figuratively called as vritti vishaya. Never a vritti vishaya, never a vishaya for anything. That's why vishaya is understood as subject matter instead of, just like yoga. Pujya Swami used to say yoga, in each and every chapter of Gita, there is yoga word. So karma yoga, bhakti yoga, Arjuna vishada yoga. Arjuna Vishada cannot be yoga. It cannot be, Yuj Samadhu. That cannot be the meaning. So it cannot be like Bhakti Yoga, Karma Yoga. Many flavors of yogas have been made and sold. And being sold, multi-billion dollar industry. It is not that yoga. Yoga is a subject. It's a topic. Similarly here, it is Vishaya. As a subject matter, it is not really object. It can never become an object. Otherwise, we will be contradicting ourselves and the Shruti. Ourselves because our Siddhanta is Shruti Siddhanta. Na prakarantarena vrittya brahmano vishayikaranam sambhavati. There is no way, in any way, if you try to explain or understand Brahma as Vishaya, it will be wrong. It is erroneous. Sakshi bahya sadhana apeksham vinayavam brahmasmiti vritti rupam tattva jnanam prakasheti. And then Sakshi does not have any bahya sadhana apeksha because Sakshi himself is Brahma. Without the bahya sadhana, aham brahmasmiti vritti rupam tattva jnanam prakasheti. There Sakshi is revealing the vritti, not Brahma. Ata eva tattva jnanam sakshi bhasyam iti abhidiyate. Therefore, tattva jnana is sakshi bhasya. Tattva is not sakshi bhasya. So there is a differentiation which should be made. Even in pratyaksha, Brahma is ever pratyaksha. Brahma jnana is not pratyaksha till it is not pratyaksha. So sakshatkara is Brahma jnana becoming. When you say Brahma sakshatkara, what it really means is that there is aparoksha or pratyaksha jnana. Brahma is ever aparoksha. Similarly, tattva is never sakshi bhasya or any bhasya. It is swabhasya. Therefore, tattva jnanam is sakshi bhasyam, natu tattvam. So, quite a long analysis has gone into this chapter and in the tippana also. Further, yatra dhuma darshanena vanni jnanam jayate tatra dhuma jnanam pratyaksham. Vanni jnanam tu na pratyaksham. In the case of parvato vanniman, the mountain has fire. That time, why do we say mountain has fire? It is anumana. Dhumatvat or dhumat. There the parvata is pratyaksha, dhuma is pratyaksha, one is not pratyaksha. So dhuma jnanam pratyaksham. So jnana about dhuma is pratyaksha. Jnana about one is not pratyaksha because one is not pratyaksha. Vanni jnanam is due to anumanam, anumana pramana. Chakshur dvara nirgata antakkarana vrittir dhumena sa sambandho asti. Now, indriya and vishaya sambandha is shown. What is happening? Chakshur indriya is connected with dhuma. Antakkarana is following chakshur indriya. So, dhuma is the vishaya where chakshur indriya has drawn the antakkarana. Antakkarana dhirhi bhava has taken place towards the dhuma. It is within and outside also. That dhirhi bhava is vritti. Vritti takes dhuma kara. That is pramadin sa sambandhosti. Ataha dhuma jnanam pratyaksham ityuchyase. इति उच्यते. सो धूम ज्ञान प्रमा इज प्रत्यक्ष बिकॉज इट इज धूमाकार. नाउ लिंग ज्ञान रूप अनुमान प्रमाण जन्य अंतकरण वृत्ति शरीर से अंतरा एव वन्याकार भजते. एंड व्हाट इज हैपनिंग हियर, लिंग ज्ञान रूप थ्रू दैट इंडिकेटर ऑफ धूम, धूम इज एन इंडिकेटर ऑफ वन्नी, इज अ लिंग फॉर वन्नी. सो लिंग ज्ञान दट धूम ज्ञान रूप अनुमान इट बिकम्स एन अनुमान, इट लीड्स टू दैट अनुमान, इट ट्रिगर्स द मेमोरी ऑफ पाकशाला. यथा पाकशालायां तथा, व्हाट इज दैट, यत्र यत्र धूमा तत्र तत्र वन्नी. Thereby अनुमान प्रमाण जन्य अंतकरण वृत्ति शरीर से अंतरायो वन्याकार भजते. सो वन्याकार वृत्ति टेक्स प्लेस विद इन, नॉट आउटसाइड. सॉरी, द व्याप्ति ट्रिगर्स, व्याप्ति थ्रू द मेमोरी ऑफ आई हैव सीन दिस, वेर एवर देर वॉज स्मोक देर वॉज फायर इन द किचन, वेन एवर देर वॉज स्मोक. सो whenever wherever there is smoke there has to be fire, with that anumana vanni jnana has taken place, because as soon as you saw the smoke fire came to mind, when fire came to mind then vanyakara vritti has taken place, it is not outside, there is a dhumakara vritti outside and inside, and that triggered vanyakara vritti not outside only inside. नहि वृत्तेर वन्निना सह संबंध अस्ति, वन्नी ऑल्दो वन्नी इज आउटसाइड देयर इज नो वन्याकार वृत्ति आउटसाइड, वन्याकार वृत्ति इज इनसाइड, देयरफॉर वन्निना सह वृत्ते संबंधो नास्ति, तस्माद् वन्नि ज्ञानं न प्रत्यक्षं, वन्नि ज्ञान इज नॉट प्रत्यक्ष, धूम ज्ञान इज प्रत्यक्ष. इत्थं यत्र वृत्त्या सह विषयस्य संबंधो होति तत्र प्रत्यक्ष ज्ञानं भवति, यत्र वृत्त्या सह विषयस्य संबंधो नास्ति तत्र परोक्ष ज्ञानं भवति. So pratyaksha jnana is aparoksha jnana when vritti is connected with the vishaya, and when vritti is not connected with the vishaya, like vanni is not connected with by the vritti inside, vanni vritti itself, but it has no connection with vanni outside, then it is called as paroksha jnana apratyaksha. Yatra vishayo deshantarasto nashto bhavi va तत्र अनुमानेन शब्देन वा विषयाकार वृत्तिः शरीरस्य अंतरायो भवति, तदो तदा उत्पद्यमानं ज्ञानं परोक्षम् इत्युच्यते. सो वेरेवर विषय इज इन अनदर देश, देशांतरस्थ नष्टः भाविव, वेदर इट इज देयर और इट इज नष्ट दैट विषय, बट इट इज आउटसाइड, आउटसाइड एज इन अनदर देश, नॉट आउटसाइड, इन अनदर अनदर प्लेस, तत्र अनुमानेन शब्देन वा विषयाकार वृत्तिः शरीरस्य अंतरा भवति, अंतरा एव भवति, बिकॉज इट इज इन सम अदर देश दैट विषय इज देयर, प्रत्यक्ष ज्ञान के नॉट टेक प्लेस, अपरोक्ष ज्ञान के नॉट टेक प्लेस, समबडी इज नरेटिंग इट, और यू नो अबाउट समथिंग, यू ट्राई टू इन्फर, ओ देयर मस्ट बी समथिंग लाइक दिस, I don't know what happens behind the Surya. I cannot see. I cannot look at Surya directly. I would like to know what is exactly behind Surya. If I can't know, then using all sorts of data available, I analyze it and I land on some conclusion that is inferred. So tatra anumana, or someone tells me this is how it is. Shastra tells me. In case of Laukika also, someone tells me, I have never traveled outside a particular country, say someone tells me in another country something like this is there. So shabdena anumana shabdena vishayakara vrittihi, vishayakara vritti does take place, but it is within the sharira, it is not outside. So vritti has no connection with the vishaya. Tada utpadyamanam jnanam paroksham ityuchyate. So that jnana is paroksha. I'll take a couple of minutes, we'll finish this off. Indriya janya jnanam yo pratyaksham iti na niyamaha. So there is no rule that indriya janya jnana, just give me one moment, I have another. सो इंद्रियजन्य ज्ञानम एव प्रत्यक्षम इति न नियमः. वी हैव सीन दिस अर्लियर. देयर नीड नॉट बी एन इंद्रिय इन्वॉल्व्ड इन प्रत्यक्ष. प्रत्यक्ष ज्ञान इज प्रत्यक्ष और अपरोक्ष इवन वेन इंद्रिय इज नॉट इन्वॉल्व्ड. वेन द वृत्ति इज विषयाकार इज कनेक्टेड विद द विषय नॉट विषयाकार वृत्ति हैज संबंध विद द विषय. सुख दुखादि ज्ञानम इंद्रियजन्य इंद्रिय अजन्यमपि प्रत्यक्षमेव भवति. So sum up is that sukha dukha example we have seen. All these are pratyaksha. We know our sukha, we know our dukha. Not through any other means. So it is pratyaksha, it is aparoksha. Directly we know it. There no indriya is involved. To know the sukha, I don't need indriya. For sukha vritti to take place, there may be indriya. But pratyakshatvam of sukha dukha adi is possible without indriyas being there. Further, dashama purusha jnanam shabda janyam api pratyaksham eva bhavati. And dashama example also we have seen where shabda janya jnana is pratyaksha to the leader who heard dashamastvamasi. Anena nyayena shri sadguru mukhar shruta mahavakya roopa veda shabda janya brahma jnanam api pratyaksham eva bhavati. Similarly, mahavakya heard from the guru is also pratyaksha, is going to give brahma jnana, which is pratyaksha, because it is shabda jnana. It will take away ajnana. Then swarupa is known by yourself, therefore pratyaksha jnana is possible. Shri sadguru evam vidam upadesham shrutva buddhiman uttamadhikari tattva drishti swatmanam brahma rupena viditva bheda brahmam vijahau. So tattva drishti gave up his ajnana by listening to the mahavakya and the elaboration. He is buddhiman uttamadhikari and thereby swatmanam brahma rupina, knowing oneself as brahma, himself as brahma. He the vikshepa also bheda brahma. Bheda may be there, pratiti may be there, but brahma is no longer there. So vikshepa being there, avarna going, there is no bheda brahma. Aham brahma smiti vritto niravaranam brahma bhati. So brahma is known as oneself then. Brahma asti bhati ahantaya tattva drishti evam uvacha. And then tattva drishti said to the guru, niravarana nirbhasam aham brahmeti buddhavan shri sadguru prasadena hyakandakar vrittitah. So through the prasad of sadguru, who has taught him, akhandakar vritti has taken place, and vrittitah tritiyarthe tasi or panchami also possible tasmat. अखंडाकार वृत्ति तहा थ्रू द अखंडाकार वृत्ति आलियुस तृतीया बुद्धवान अहम बुद्धवान व्हाट ब्रह्म इति अहम ब्रह्म इति बुद्धवान. हाउ सो निरावरण निर्भासम दी अखंडाकार वृत्ति हैज टेकन अवे आवरण एंड देन द सेल्फ शाइनिंग मी इज नोन एज ब्रह्म due to Sadguru's teaching. Iti Shri Vasudev Brahmendra Saraswati Virachite Vichara Sagare Uttamadhikarinaha Upadesha Nirupanam Nama Chaturthas Tarangaha. Here the Tippanakara says, Yasya Antakkarnam Purva Punya Paripaka Vashad Atyantam Shuddhamasti Yasya Guru Padishta Mahavakya Rupa Shabda Pramanena Sudrudo Bodho Jataha. So whose Antakkarna is Shuddha, who has Chitta Shuddhi because of purva punya, thereby guru upadishta mahavakya rupa shabda pramanena sudrudo bodho jataha. So then chitta shuddhi is there, uttama adhikarittvam is praptam, thereby the adhikari gets the jnana, firm knowledge by guru upadesha of mahavakya. Yasya cha tadrusha sudrudo bodho dayanantaram संशयादि निवृत्तये श्रवणादि साधनानंतरम न अपेक्षितम स एव उत्तम अधिकारी. When that kind of bodha takes place, shabda bodha, mahavakya is known, understood, and as aham brahmasmi, and there are no obstacles, doubts are not pending. Thereby, shravanadi sadhana is not needed. After shravanadi sadhana, shravana manana nididhyasana, na apekshitam, shravanadi sadhanantaram na apekshitam. Mahavakya Upadesha has taken place. Here, if you look at it, elaboration is given, but there is not much of elaboration in terms of prakriyas. Every story is not mentioned here. No srishti prakriya, nothing of that sort. So, Shravana, only Mahavakya has been elaborated. Initially started by saying that it is a pratiti for you, you yourself are that. Nothing else is needed. He is Uttamadhikari. Yasya tu antakkaranam na atyantam shuddham. Kintu ishan malavikshepadi dosha yuktam. Who is an adhikari but not Uttamadhikari. Why? Because antakkarana is not atyanta shuddha. In the earlier case it was atyanta shuddha. There is some malavikshepa. Then what will happen? You know, on and off, the person slips into all sorts of things that one was doing earlier. Generally tuned towards Shravana, but then many a time slips. Sa Madhyama Adhikari, Athava Kanishta Adhikari. So he is either has a qualification of middle level or a lower level. Meaning he is an Adhikari, but still will take time. May need multiple prakriyas, may need multiple rounds of study. Shravana, Manana, Nididhyasana should continue to take away obstacles. And even the earlier sadhana may need, you know, may be needed to keep the shuddhi and make the chittam more shuddha. Mahavakya rupa shabdad aparoksha jnano dayanantaram api samshayadi nivruttaye tena shravanadikam anushteyam. He has to continue shravana and just mahavakya won't do. He has to, mahavakya may in fact make him a new Vedanti. If he keeps on doing everything as earlier and does not work on the chitta shuddhi, then he may have a wrong understanding of the Upanishad. So that is the fourth chapter. We'll continue with the fifth chapter in the next part. Sukan nityam swaprakasham vyapakam namurga adhishthanam buddhyabodhyam buddher nukyatnin aparam sarvedanta vidyam pratyak paramha tadevahannam attonyat iti me nishchita matihi tatsat. I'll see you in the next part. Namaste.
Hariom.